Good morning, children. Now, as you all know, we are doing chapter number 1. In the previous video, you all have seen the process of photosynthesis. You have also learned about autotrophs, heterotrophs, saprotrophs. Please watch the videos carefully and do the assignment side by side for better understanding. Use PDF also, the chapter which we are downloading of NCERT for the further reference. Again and again we are repeating this because we all know that you are not having books right now. So please read the chapters from the NCERT books which we are uploading on the ERP and then see the videos and try to do the assignments for the better understanding. Wish you all good luck. Few topics are left of this chapter which I am going to cover today. The first topic is cell. The next topic is how nutrients are replenished in the soil. And the last, I am going to take a quick revision of this chapter. Now, come to the cell. You know what is cell? A cell is the basic unit of life. Cell is structural and functional unit of life. You all know, children, as when we build a building, it is made up of bricks. In the same way, the bodies of living organism are made up of tiny units called cells. Cells can only be seen under the powerful microscope, and the some organism which are made up of only one cell, they are called unicellular. And the organism which are made up of many cells, they are called multicellular. You all have learned in chapter number 2 also, like amoeba, which is made up of one cell, that is unicellular. And human being is made up of many cells, so it is called multicellular organism. The cell is enclosed by thin outer boundary called the cell membrane. This I'll explain you further in the diagram also. Most cells have a distinct centrally located spherical structure called the nucleus. And the nucleus is surrounded by a jelly-like substance called cytoplasm. So you all take out your loose sheets and note it down as a form of notes on it for better understanding. This is the diagram of the cell, which is drawn in your book also. And now I am going to show you. The first is cell membrane. The outer covering I told you of this cell is known as cell membrane. Here you can see. Inner, a fluid-like structure present in it is called the cytoplasm. And the centrally located spherical structure is known as nucleus. So the diagram of cell is clear to all. Draw it again in your notebook and please remember it side by side. So now the diagram of cell is clear to all. Okay. Now come to the next topic, that how the nutrients are replenished in the soil. You know the meaning of replenished? I hope. Replenished means finished, exhausted, over. I think it is clear to you all. Now, number one, children, it is very important to understand that have you ever seen that farmers are spreading or putting nutrients or fertilizer in the soil? You have seen in your home also, at your houses, where you are growing the plants. Sometimes when gardener is coming, he used to put some fertilizers in the pots. What is that meant for? That is for improvement, for the growth of the plant and to keep them safe from all the plant diseases. So, the very, very important nutrient that is required for the soil is, yes, nitrogen. In all the fertilizers, in all the manures, the major, the important component is nitrogen. So do you know why they are added to the soil and where do the plants get from? very, very important to understand. So plant require nutrient such as carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and so on. You all know they get carbon dioxide from the air, hydrogen from the water. As you all know, water means H2O. And all other nutrients are absorbed from the soil. Again, my question is, then where does nitrogen comes in the soil? One of the most essential nutrients absorbed from the soil is called nitrogen. Due to this, the nitrogen in the soil gets depleted. The nitrogen needs to be added from time to time to the replenish the soil. So children, nitrogen is, you all know, you all have read in class 6, the composition of air. You all know 78% of nitrogen is present in the air, which is in the gaseous form. But plants cannot obtain this directly. They have to take it in which form? In soluble form. How do they get? Now listen and read carefully. Planting plant such as peas and beans alternatively with other crops. This maintain the nitrogen in the soil. Rhizobium, it is the name of the bacteria which is very, very important. Rhizobium present in such plants convert atmospheric nitrogen into water soluble form that is absorbed by the plant along with the water. So I think now it is clear to you all how the nitrogen is maintained in the soil. So which is the major important component? Rhizobium, it is the name of the bacteria. Next point is adding fertilizer containing nitrogen to the soil. Now I'm giving you one homework. Use your Google, use your common sense, use your alternative method and write down the name of any 5 fertilizer or manure which contain nitrogen. I am giving you one example. One is nitrogen phosphate. In this way, there are many fertilizers and I am telling you one thing, that nitrogen is the main component which is present in each and every fertilizer. Now, by crop rotation method, listen to me very, very carefully. What is this crop rotation? If you grow one crop for continuously, then what will happen? They will take all the important components from the soil, and when you grow it next time, that will be replenished. So when you use one crop one time and next time use another crop, then automatically by natural methods, they will regain their nutrients automatically. So we have to use the crop rotation method. Now, next is the important, what is the role of rhizobium bacteria in the soil? Just now I told you, its main function is to convert gaseous nitrogen into soluble form. Now, some like gram, peas, moong, beans, etc. are legumes. You all know these are the lentils, dals used in our homes. The roots of these crops have nodules on them. These nodules have symbiotic bacteria. These bacteria have the property. These bacteria have the property to convert atmospheric nitrogen into nitrates. I told you these nitrates are soluble in water and can provide nitrogen to the plants. Thus, the rhizobium bacteria can convert atmospheric nitrogen into soluble nitrogen. Very important question. So whatever topics we are discussing here, children, on the regular basis, we are giving you very short assignment for the better understanding After learning from these videos, please, please do the assignments side by side. Otherwise, it will be pending for you and difficult for you to cover it up. So this chapter is clear. I'm repeating important points of this chapter once again. And I hope when tomorrow after this, I will upload assignments. It is easy for you to do it. And if you are not able to do it, answer key is also available within day or two. Take help from that and try to complete the work. Number two, children, please keep in mind, whichever chapter we'll cover here on the videos, we will not repeat in the classes again. So for better understanding, watch the videos twice, understand it well. Self-study is the best study. Read the books. If you're not having the books, use the PDF. Don't use mobiles. Use your laptops or desktop so that it will not give stress to your eyes also. Firstly, you all have done. Now do the quick revision of this chapter. I hope you are able to give answers yourself now. Solar energy is stored in the form of food in the leaves with the help of chlorophyll. You all have understood in a better way the process of photosynthesis. Oxygen is produced in abundance in great amount in the process of photosynthesis. Next point, oxygen released in photosynthesis is utilized by living organism for their survival. Next point, fungi derive the nutrition from dead and decaying matter. They are called saprotrophs. Plant like cascata are parasites. They take food from the host plant. A few plants and other animals are dependent on others for their nutrition. So those who depend upon others, they are called heterotrophs. And I told you, those who make their food themselves, they are called autotrophs. All organisms take food and utilize it to get energy for the growth and maintenance of their bodies. You all know importance of food, which you all have done. Green plants synthesize their foods themselves by the process of photosynthesis. They are called autotrophs. Now, one thing here you will learn and understood that what is the difference between autotrophs and heterotrophs. Again, I'm repeating. Auto means preparing their food on their own. And hetero means depending on others for their food. Plant use very simple chemical substances like carbon dioxide, water, and mineral for the synthesis of food. Chlorophyll and sunlight are the essential requirement for photosynthesis. All four components are important, but chlorophyll and sunlight are very, very essential. Complex chemical substances such as carbohydrate are the products of photosynthesis. Means when all these sunlight, chlorophyll, when they react together, water and carbon dioxide, what is formed? Carbohydrate and a great amount of oxygen. So I think now this chapter is clear to you all. All the points are clear to you. Try your back exercise yourself. You will get back exercise key points also, answers also. And have a good day. Good luck. See you tomorrow.